Hey guys, it's Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off. He got past Juventus in the Champions in the first knockouts of the game in the Champions League, beating him in the second leg. Almost forgot I scored like a really sneaky goal right at the end. It was 3-0, but then that goal made 4-0, obviously. Dirt. Which made 8-2 on aggregate. That's the final score, which was mad considering the first leg ended 4-2, which is why I played the second leg at all. And I also picked up a win in the league over Norwich. And I have a big game coming up today. No offense to Watford and to the FA Cup, but this is it. This is, well, this game is important in its own way. It's the quarter final, if I am correct. I think it is. Yeah, it is. So we are down to the final 8 in the FA Cup, getting down to the knee-grease, and we will be employing only the main squad. But the game I have after this is, which, unless the schedule is changed between now and then, is currently set to be Stoke in the Premier League.
Two guys might have an influence on,
and the reason that's important is, you're probably saying, Stoke, well, you're undefeated, so why is this game against Stoke important? Well, it's because if I win that game against Stoke, I win the Premier League. That's why it's important. I'm currently 31 points ahead of second place, which at the moment is Crystal Palace again, because of various results, like Manchester United and Arsenal drawing 1-0 at the Emirates, and Chelsea losing 2-0 at Goodison Park. Yep, Chelsea are practically out of the title race, and it's all thanks to my blue neighbors. I can't imagine that would suck if that happened to Everton in real life. Like, if they won a match that pretty much all but handed the league title to Liverpool, oh, they would be fucking disgusted. That'd be like, they'd be like, oh, for fuck's sake. That's an own goal, what the? Well, let's. That's one way to start off the scoring in the 18th minute. It's actually Emery Moore, who is my number 18, and who put the ball into the box. So that's a bit interesting. The West Brom. Watford, not West Brom. The Watford fans. Slip of the tongue there, sorry. Yeah, I didn't mean to call you. That Cambasio? I'm probably butchering his name, but the Belgian centre back is the man who has gotten the unfortunate
to attack
opener. I mean, he'd be celebrating. He'd be lucky if that had happened at the other end, but unfortunately for him, his own keeper punched the ball right into him, and nothing he could do. So he was more focused on trying to stop the ball from getting to the booker. He didn't have any time to move out of the way or avoid the ball. He's into the word.
What a corner!
Corner attack. Hey, who's accidentally put the ball over the play for a corner. So, that's coming, but it'll be a relief for Watford on that occasion.
Berami. Jeje. Good forward play from them. He's better usually at crossing than that.
There from the big bank there. He cleared it.
Nordin Amrabat. Got the tackle in. At the moment, it's looking quite good for Liverpool. But only quite good. They would have hoped to be in a
strong position. Ojo! Oh.
Ticket, as they say, and fair play to him for having a crack.
Not the person you want on the end of the header. No offense, Shay. Okay, but you're really not. But on a dribble, well, Ojo is great. Oh, and Emery turned into trouble. Well, he couldn't get anything other than blocked.
Good clearance.
The official has indicated there will be a minimum of 3 minutes of added time.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Here comes the cross.
Oh! Another defensive glamour! And Emery Moore reaps the reward.
They played well to this point. Sometimes a two-goal lead can be a dangerous one. We'll see. Well, it was a gift.
This time Origi puts the ball in. Who else? I'm not sure how I pronounce the dude's name. But he chests it. The freaking keeper is diving at his feet trying to collect the ball. Oh, he's not sure what's going on. The ball falls kindly for Emery Moore. He puts it in. And he has 4 goals in the FA Cup. Up 2 defensive calamities. And Watford are completely not having a good time.
Yeah, I mean, I'd be surprised if they just sat back and defended this lead because they're capable of getting to it.
I mean, I don't need help, but the fact that 2 of their center backs have attributed to the damage done, one self-inflicted and the other are literally assisted that goal. Well, I mean, is it? My strikers assisted both goals. They didn't score both goals.
The Emirates FA Cup.
Well, the players
more assisted. He assisted that calamity of an own goal that was the opener. And he reaped the reward, as I said, from the calamity in defense that led to the second goal. For which the ball came in from Origi.
Pereira. Not a turnover in play here with that interception.
Alexander Arnold. Fouled by Kapu? No, he's not been fouled by Kapu. But that's a foul! Oh, fuck off!
Well, time is ticking away. It's time for a change in
here it comes. Raheem's game is ending.
Good strong.
Chances are his FA Cup time in this season is up. Origi! Oh, Proto. Well, I got it right that time. Proto cleared it this time instead of contributing more to the damage.
They cope with it well defensively.
Rich.
Well, they're in a good position here.
Origi! He'll have another goal! Why did he header it? Origi! Good save. I mean, the shot wasn't very good, but credit where credit is due.
Coming up for you on EA Sports.
Because the next fixture is right now, anyway. Because this game likes to randomly change the fixtures whenever it seems fit.
Still 20 minutes to go. They'll need to try and get the ball back now. Really strong tackle, and the ball's gone out for a throw. Here's a chance to attack.
Rigi.
And the cross comes.
Oops,
in
the ball in again. And Chiozzo in the corner.
A clear corner.
Off the offered right back. Because leg to up in the perfect position to block it. Right now, Clemen! Unlikely to score in two games in a row. Oh, because he scored that sneaky fourth goal I mentioned against Juventus, in case you didn't see the last episode. But on a Friday.
Well, it's going to be a substitution now.
Blanc. Oh, goddammit. 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 Good. It's a hit from Finn here to make up for a little bit of a blunder from myself.
Attacking well here. Very weak challenge.
More.
One or two players are warming up.
Trying to fuck. And room. Every more!
Quite what he was hoping for.
But when he's hit it, I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
Time is ticking away here. 4 minutes to go. Onto the attack now.
The Blanc. The Blanc. Oh, it's another own goal! No, it didn't. Oh, it didn't go in. I thought it was in. And I thought it might have gone. I thought it was after go in. Again off of Kimba. That's it. Go. Go for another own goal. Boom. Freaking hell. Talk about unlucky. And he fortunately, his luck was in that time, and it went wide for the corner.
And the decision, and in comes the header. That's great defending there, stopping that.
Oh, that clears it.
Could be dangerous.
Ojo. Emre Moore! Over the bar, and that's the end of the game. 2-0 is the final score. Or all the damage done to Watford was pretty much self-inflicted. No one but to blame but themselves, really. I mean,
well, he's had a very good
one
game,
was an own goal, and the other was assisted by a Watford player. So, yeah, not a good game to be a Watford player. Chelsea lost to Leicester. Your two quarterfinals you can see are Spurs and Nottingham Forest, West Ham and Villa. To Clareton.
The Football Association Challenge Cup. Quarter final. Chelsea 1, Leicester City 2. Watford.
I was going to say two Premier League Clareton Blue teams, but Villa got relegated. But luckily, he Burnley filled in that position, I guess. Because they wear the same colour, don't they? was that about West Brom? I think it said a game against West Brom got rescheduled to the 28th. I mean, this game against Stoke is here, regardless. The United game got rescheduled. I think that was because of the FA Cup. No. PSG. Oh, maybe it was saying it was moved from a 28th fixture. Spurs are my opposition in the semi-final of the FA Cup, and PSG are who I will take on next in the Champions League. But the bigger story is the Premier League right now. Oops. I forgot to switch back to the teams, my bad. Oh, Sunday and Monday went up to 83. When did he do that? I mean, the dude should be way higher up in ratings considering how many goals the dude scores. Anyway, here we go. So, the game that will crown me the Premier League champions 2 seasons running. Again. Still haven't lost the Premier League game. Stoke are aiming to be the first. I still haven't dropped any points officially in the Premier League. Stoke, again, are aiming to be the first. If they're not, then the Premier League title is staying at Anfield. Until someone comes to give me a challenge, because this season has been a walkover.
Game today, Liverpool against Stoke City.
I am actually going to win the Premier League title with 10 games remaining. That's just not right. That doesn't sound right. I know I've been dominant, but everyone else has been utter garbage.
Nathaniel Clyne starts with David Alaba as the fullbacks. Mahmoud Dahoud plays with Emre Can in central midfield. And the strike force, Sadio Mane, joins up front with Daniel Sturridge. The Stoke City team, here it is for you. Eric Peters starts, despite looking shaky in recent games.
Sturridge. I'm waiting to challenge. Gives it to Bobby Firmino. Penalty! An early penalty. I think it's been conceded by Peters. No, it's Sophie. I have no idea who the fuck this dude is. Can this keeper be the first to save a David Alaba penalty? He is! David Alaba is no longer perfect on penalties. I knew it as soon as I saw the keeper go the right way. Hey, I should have put it high. Ah! Is that a sign for Stoke?
He's got the ball away from him with the tackle. Some potential in this move.
Nathaniel Clyne. Where's left back compatriot? Perfect. He couldn't succeed in Sayama. And he was always struggling to direct that goal. Hurts. I was more trying to keep it in rather than trying to put it into the net with Sayama.
Jordan Shaqiri. David Alaba commits the foul.
David Alaba has been penalised. And that's a yellow card!
Oh, absolutely fuck off. That is not a yellow card.
Yeah, he reached for that back pocket.
That player had more contact on my dude, who then he didn't give him a yellow card.
Back very quickly. Chan.
So am I.
Got the tackle in.
Sturridge! Oh! I was pressing circle trying to get him to hit it. But he didn't react.
He thought he might have connected a bit better than that.
And I've accidentally hit it with Coutinho. Oh. Who am I disbelief? Say am I.
Too early, offside.
Side.
Across the line. Well read by the defender. That will be Liverpool's throw in. Roberto Firmino.
Bobby Firmino. Daniel Sturridge.
Chance to get in the cross. He's got the ball.
There, corner.
Danger momentarily, but it is a corner following that good tackle.
Mane. Sturridge. Firmino! I didn't hit that properly! Damn it! I didn't put any kind of power into the Firmino. Push. Oh,
setups and
storage.
Could he be a manager at an international level?
Get up, Daniel, for fuck's sake.
Tactically, he's proven himself to be quite a.
No time for simulation. Emre Can. Coutinho. Dude! Oh!
I was expecting him to be wheeling away in celebration there.
Almost everyone in the. The team has had a shot at goal, I think, except barring my centre backs and goalkeeper. And maybe Emre Can. Sadio Mane! Sadio Mane! Oh, even Sadio Mane! He's got. Also, I just can't provide so far. I thought I would capitalize on that, but I didn't react quickly enough to the keeper hitting it off of, I think that time it definitely was Pierce.
Regarding added time, could be dangerous.
Joe Matip! Oh! Now only Lover and freaking Karius have not had a shot, because Joe Matip just had one. Come on, that has got to be a yellow card for Bojan. Bojan, sorry.
Out comes the yellow card. Well, he reached straight through his pocket. He didn't really think about it, but I think that's the good call.
Firmino! Oh my gosh. This is actually fucking believable.
45 minutes still to go. Second half underway. Jerdan Shaqiri. Bojan. He's coming forward with some danger. Looking to play his teammate through. Challenges.
Sorry, I think I said Dejan Lovren. I meant Nicolas Sewell. I'm thinking real life. Good combo. Dejan Sturridge! Blocked by Ewok. And Sturridge was so pissed off he fucking body slammed him.
Good forward play from them.
Firmino.
That will be a corner.
Wheeling concedes another corner. Serge! Matip! Oh! Matip has another opportunity that goes awry.
Excellent control in a tight area. In comes the challenge. Saw the pass coming and got there first.
Sadio Mane. De Hood.
Corner to come.
Peters concedes the corner.
It's interesting, the corner count to this point.
Play it short to Mane. This normally works. So, I don't have him on the bench! I'm gonna call upon Divo Origi and the ever impressing Trent Alexander-Arnold. Mane. Daniel Sturridge. Coutinho. Firmino. Oh. He couldn't make an impact. Neither him nor Sturridge can make the impact. Means Origi and Alexander-Arnold are going to be on now. Coutinho avoids the challenge. Blocked by Henderson. The irony.
Really strong tackle.
Trent Alexander-Arnold. What was that?
Stoke have worked hard in this game to get where they are, and they're defending that position. Alan Smith.
Well, they might not have much of an outlet. They've got nobody left up front. They're just defending in numbers, en masse.
Well, they're still battling to try and get their...
Origi! Oh! Alaba. Coutinho.
One thing having possession, but another thing being positive.
Philippe Coutinho!
The keeper.
Mane. It's cleared away by Bojan. So. Oh, he's like the only player not to. And him and Emery Chan. Origi! Oh! Origi! What a stroke of luck, Divo Origi! He. Who missed. The end of last. He's only came back with like three games to spare. In the Premier League season, may have scored the winning goal this season. True bit of luck. The Belgian does it. And Mark Hughes must be absolutely livid. He looks so calm. You wouldn't think that was a goal that a team that has been pretty much wall, so annoying to get through. So, pretty much as soon as I went all out attack to try and like pile more men forward in attempt to get that winner, Origi almost instantly scored. What's gonna happen here? Divo Origi, it's Emre Can. I said he was one of the ones who hadn't had a shot. Almost immediately, it's a misery compiler. Emre Can adds a second. Divo Origi has an assist. It's the Premier League title and the win are surely in the bag. Emre Can. In overtime for him to get his name on the list of the players who've had at least one shot against Stoke today. I mean, the only outfield players who've not had a pop at the Stoke goal in this game are Trent Alexander-Arnold and Nicholas Sewell and my in-goalkeeper of Loris Karius.
Well, that was shoddy from Stoke, wasn't it? Now they've got
Andreas will be remembered as the first man to save a David Alaba a penalty in his Liverpool old days. But he couldn't prevent the Origi goal. He couldn't prevent the Emirates angle. Oh no, Mane is running at him. Origi might score again. Origi has scored again. That has definitely sealed it. The Premier League title is won. Divock Origi. He again missed the majority of the season in Turin last season. And despite all of the goals scored by Sam and Daniel Sturridge, it's Divock Origi who makes himself the true hero. Oh, I'm not going to discount Emre Can, but Divock Origi scored the crucial first goal and the killing third goal. The second goal was kind of a killer anyway, but the third goal has absolutely sealed it. There's nothing that can be done now. It doesn't matter or what other results happen in the Premier League. The Premier League title is secure for another season.
Coming forward with some danger. Here comes the challenge.
And there is the full time whistle. It is job done once again. The players are running onto the pitch because they know. Divock Origi, so wait to the crowd while you can, dude. You're probably about to be mauled. Hello? Dude just scored the quite possibly two of the most important goals of the season. Look at that. Again, in the title deciding match, I left it late. Emery Moore last season scoring 80 plus minute, a crucial goal. Oh, there's the moment that I screwed up. I self-admittedly, he should have scored that penalty. And the follow-up wasn't much better. I hit straight at the post. That was bullshit. Alba did almost nothing to Glenn Johnson and he got yellow. Sadio Mane couldn't even put the ball in the back of the net. And that's how bad it got. But in the end, it's not mattered. Divock Origi and Emre Can and pull off the headline grabbing news. Whose goals? Well,
Norwich City 0, Newcastle United 2, Swansea City 2.
No, I suppose it would be headline grabbing.
On the league standings, at the top of the table remain Liverpool with 84 points. In second, climbing the table, are Arsenal with 52 points. In third,
a double from a Belgian and a single from a German. And the league title is mine again. Next episode.
Tottenham Hotspur with 41.
Would you also
with 39 points.
The first leg against PSG and the game against Manchester United. Yes, it doesn't really matter, but I gotta keep that undefeated streak alive. I'm probably gonna simulate the games against Brighton. Hull and Swansea off camera because now they do not matter. Until next time. So, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button for a second league win in 2 seasons. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.